Hello and welcome back to this channel. Dear students, this topic is program and data memory organization for PIC microcontroller. There are two types of memory locations, two major types of memory locations. One is program memory and another is data memory. As far as this PIC microcontroller is concerned, separate buses are allocated to both program as well as data memory, so simultaneously these two memory locations can be accessed. अब ये जो present we are talking about program memory organization. Exam point of view से आप लोग direct question expect कर सकते हो कि draw the program memory organization or write the functioning of or elaborate the program memory organization or program memory mapping. So this is the ब्लॉक स्कीमेटिक फॉर प्रोग्राम मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ये जो ब्लॉक्स दिखे हैं, दिस इज फॉर द स्टैक. सो देर आर 31 लेवल्स एज फार एज स्टैक इज कंसर्न. स्टैक लेवल 1, स्टैक लेवल 2, अप टू स्टैक लेवल 31. ये जो स्टैक है, इट इज नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ प्रोग्राम मेमोरी. नाउ वी नो दैट दिस स्टैक इज सिमिलर टू द स्टैक वी स्टडीड इन माइक्रोकंट्रोलर 8051. देन what's the major function of this program memory? The program memory is used to store the instructions which are required for execution of any program, and it is also required in many applications to store the data tables of the fixed data. So this is the major use of program memory. अब जैसे मैंने बताया stack के 31 levels है, and so 31 level stack holds return address of interrupt and subroutine. मतलब जब भी हम कोई interrupt occur होगा या we are talking about any subroutine, so return address must be stored. That is the major function of this stack. But as I said, stack is not the part of program memory. It has 21 bit RAM and 5 bit of stack pointer. SP means stack pointer. अब this part is the part of program memory. देखो यहां से connection दिखा है, this is called user memory space. So it is starting from reset vector whose address is allocated as 0000H. H stands for hexadecimal. So reset vector is the address at which microcontroller begins after reset. मतलब कोई भी resetting करने के बाद new programming should start at some certain location, so that is provided by the reset vector. Then it assigns 16 bytes. अब देखो ये reset vector के बाद हमने दो block बनाया है, priority interrupts for high priority interrupts and low priority interrupts. There are two types of priorities, one is higher and one is lower priority. This for the higher priority interrupt, the address is 0008H. That means higher priority interrupt vector address starts from 0008H, whereas low priority interrupt vector starting address is 0018H. So it assigns 16 microcontroller assigns 16 bytes to high priority ISR interrupt subroutine by default, but for the low priority interrupt service routine, the size is not fixed. So for low priority ISR can have any size. Now 21 bit PC, that is program counter, is used. We already discussed the functioning of program counter while studying the architecture. So 21 bit program counter through which 2 megabyte program memory space can be accessed. So basically program counter is used to access the memory space. To program counter is of 21 bits and it is used to access 2 megabyte program memory space. This program counter basically holds the address of instructions in the memory. Now 32 kilobytes of flash memory which can store, matlab ye jo memory hai, on chip memory, it is basically 32 kilobytes flash memory which can store 16k single instructions. ये जो रीड जीरो स्पेस है, दैट इज फॉर नो एनओपी ऑपरेशन, नॉप ऑपरेशन, और इट इज अनइम्प्लीमेंटेड एरिया. सो दिस इज अबाउट द मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ पिक 18F. द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज डेटा मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. दिस डायग्राम इंडिकेट्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ डेटा मेमोरी. अब देखो एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से अगेन यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट द डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन लाइक एक्सप्लेन द डेटा मेमोरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और डेटा मेमोरी मैपिंग. तो जैसे मैंने बताया ये डायग्राम में दिस डायग्राम इंडिकेट्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ डेटा मेमोरी. इट इज इंप्लीमेंटेड एज स्टैटिक रैम विच इज एब्रीवेटेड एज एस रैम, स्टैटिक रैंडम एक्सेस मेमोरी. अब देखो इस डायग्राम में जैसे दिखाया है देर आर 16 बैंक्स, बैंक 0, बैंक 1, बैंक 2 अप टू बैंक 15. तो ये जो और कुछ एब्रीवेशन यूज किए मैंने GPR, दीज आर जनरल पर्पज रजिस्टर्स. डेटा मेमोरी मतलब इट इज द ग्रुप ऑफ रजिस्टर्स. सो देर आर वेरियस जनरल पर्पज रजिस्टर्स. अब देखो लास्ट बैंक जो है दैट इज बैंक 15, उसका हब पोर्शन इट इज SFR दैट इज स्पेशल फंक्शन रजिस्टर. एंड द अपर आई मीन अपर पोर्शन ऑफ बैंक जीरो, अपर हब पोर्शन ऑफ बैंक जीरो विच इज आई हैव रिटन इट एज एक्सेस रैम. मतलब इसका आधा पोर्शन और इसका आधा पोर्शन लेके एक बैंक तैयार किया है दैट इज रेफर्ड एज एक्सेस बैंक. सो एक्सेस बैंक इज क्रिएटेड आई मीन इट इज अ वर्चुअल बैंक विच इज जनरेटेड बाय टेकिंग हब पोर्शन ऑफ बैंक जीरो एंड हब पोर्शन ऑफ बैंक 15. सबके एड्रेसेस मैंने लिखे इन टर्म्स ऑफ हेक्साडेसिमल्स. सो टोटल 4 KB किलोबाइट्स डेटा मेमोरी इज ऑर्गेनाइज इन 16 बैंक्स, बैंक 0 टू बैंक 15. तो टोटल डेटा मेमोरी है 4 KB. देन एवरी लोकेशन इन द डेटा मेमोरी इज कॉल्ड फाइल रजिस्टर और सिंपली रजिस्टर. रजिस्टर इज अ डिवाइस विच इज यूज टू स्टोर द डेटा और स्टोर द एड्रेस. सो एवरी लोकेशन इन बैंक इज कॉल्ड फाइल रजिस्टर और सिंपली रजिस्टर. Totally, there are 4096 file registers and it is divided into 16 banks. Dekho, total number of banks 16 and total file registers or simply total registers are 4096. So, every register contains, I mean every bank contains 4096 upon 16, that is 256 bytes. Kyunki total number of registers are 4096 and there are 16 banks. Then, a bank is accessed by using BSR, Bank Select Register. So, by using BSR, Bank Select Register, any bank can be accessed. And at a time, any one of the banks will be active. All the banks cannot be active at the same time. So, to access any bank, lower 4 bits of Bank Select Registers are used, whereas the upper 4 bits are unimplemented. Total 8 bits are used. Now, as I mentioned, half of the bank 0 and bank 15 forms a virtual bank, which is called Access Bank. Then, there are two types of registers. One is GPR, that is General Purpose Register. Everywhere we have written it. It is used to store data for different program modules and applications. And second is Special Function Registers, which is used for certain controlling operations, like related to some peripheral devices. Then data memory can be accessed directly or indirectly. Matlab, there are two types of access by which you can transfer the data to the data memory or read the data from the data memory. That is direct method or indirect method. अब जैसे देखो हम लोग instruction learn करने वाले हैं PIC microcontroller के instruction में there is one bit which is called A bit. If value of A bit is 1, it indicates BSR, that is you are supposed to access the data memory using bank select register. And if value of A is 0, by default you are access bank. I mean access bank address mapping is indicated by A is equals to 0. That means default you are using access bank. जैसे मैंने बताया ये access bank है, इसमें half portion is GPR general purpose register, remaining half portion is FSR special function register taken from the lower part of bank number 15. The next part is reset control register, that is RCON. अब देखो इससे पहले भी हम लोगों ने एक और एक register learn किया that is status register or flag register which we already discussed, which is giving indication of certain flags like carry flag, overflow flag and so on. Now, this is another type of register, reset control register, that is RCON. Ye bit number 0, this is bit number 7. जो जो यहाँ पे एब्रीविएशंस लिखे उसका मीनिंग मैंने लिख के रखा है, IPEN, आई मीन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट बिट नंबर 7, इट इज इंटरप्ट प्रायोरिटी इनेबल बिट, इंटरप्ट प्रायोरिटी इनेबल बिट. सो इफ दिस बिट इज 1, इट इंडिकेट्स दैट इंटरप्ट इज इनेबल्ड, इंटरप्ट प्रायोरिटी इज इनेबल्ड, एंड 0 इंडिकेट्स द इंटरप्ट प्रायोरिटी इज डिसेबल्ड. देन दिस 2 बिट्स आर अनयूज्ड, दैट इज बिट नंबर 6 एंड 5. देन RI बार, that is reset instruction flag, reset instruction flag. So if this bit is 1, it indicates that resetting operation is not executed. And if this bit position or this bit content is 0, it indicates that reset operation has been executed. Next is TO bar, that is watchdog timer out flag. So its contents are, if this bit is 1, it indicates the occurrence of clear or sleep instruction, and if it is 0, it indicates that watchdog timer is time out. Next is PD bar, that is power down detection flag. So as the name indicates, if this bit is 1, if this bit is set to 1 after power up is done, that means power is switched on at that time, whenever power is switched on at that time, this bit is 1, and it is 0 when after the execution of sleep instruction, sleep or clear instruction. Next is POR bar, that is power on reset status flag. So power on reset status flag, these bits are 1, indicates that power on reset has not occurred. Dekho, ye POR jo hai, that is power on reset status flag. Matlab power on reset occur ho gaya nahi, iska indication is bit se milega. So if it is 1, it indicates POR, power on reset, is not occurred. If it is 0, it indicates power on reset has occurred. Last bit, I mean bit number 0 is BOR, that is brown out reset status flag. This is again one of the types of register. Ye hum log baad mein bhi learn karne wale detail mein. So brown out reset means if bit is 1, it indicates that brown out reset has occurred and is not occurred, and for 0, it indicates that brown out reset has been occurred. So dear students, that's it for program and data memory organization of PIC microcontroller. So thank you, thanks a lot for watching this video.